Welcome everyone to our Spunotech channel. This is Sorov. The seafarer community, which plays a very crucial role in today's society from medicine to transportation. Almost all major sectors today are directly or indirectly dependent on smooth running of ships, but very often, the seafarer community is one of the most neglected, and often taken casually or its contribution is not even acknowledged. The recent COVID pandemic, it has added more salt to its wound. In this video, we would like to share and acknowledge with the society a minuscule of its pain to honor the seafarers, which they rightfully deserves. A British seafarer was yearning to see her family, who needed her help in the face of the COVID-19 epidemic, and she was resolved to be there for them. Her plans to return home in mid-March, however, were thwarted. The port state's immigration authorities first rejected permission to travel since the regulations had been revised with little warning. The seafarer was stranded at anchor, with no way of getting home. She emailed IMO on March 31st, pleading for assistance. "I am so desperate to return home, as I am sure is the situation for so many other seafarers right now. I can't concentrate about anything else since my mom and grandparents are vulnerable," she explained. The seafarer went on to say that her mental health had been severely harmed, and she believed that her ability to execute her duties as a bridge officer had been harmed as well. The IMO quickly notified the port and seafarers, as well as the appropriate NGOs. These initiatives aided in the case's resolution. The seafarer was permitted to fly home on April 12 after coordination between the local seafarers union and the port state. In another incident, the International Maritime Organization, IMO, received notification of an emergency situation on board a cargo vessel at anchor on May 14, 2020. Due to a swelling that had extended from his gum to the left side of his face and half of his neck, a top officer was in excruciating discomfort. The ship's captain and charterer had sought a doctor's visit 5 days beforehand, but customs officials turned them down due to COVID-related limitations. A doctor verified the necessity for immediate surgery during a video consultation, citing the significant danger of sepsis. Every day, the seafarer's health deteriorated, and he was already frail and unable to walk. On board, his colleagues and the master were concerned for the seafarer's safety. "It is very difficult to understand that in such dangerous situation there is no proper support to save the life of a human," one colleague remarked in an email message. Following notification of the situation, the IMO's Seafarer Crisis Action Team, SCAT, in collaboration with the ICS and the ITF, quickly intervened and contacted the port state and the seafarer's home state's focal points. The matter was resolved after intense talks and solid teamwork. But not everyone is fortunate like them. Due to COVID-related travel limitations, an estimated 200,000 seafarers are now stuck on ships beyond the end of their original contracts and unable to be repatriated as of March 2021. Similarly, a large number of sailors are stranded at home, unable to board ships and support their families. A considerable number of seafarers, as well as their wives and family members, have contacted the International Maritime Organization, express their worries about the COVID-19 epidemic, which has resulted in a range of unpleasant situations. To assist in the resolution of individual cases, the International Maritime Organization established the Seafarer Crisis Action Team, SCAT, which frequently collaborates with other organizations such as the International Labor Organization, ILO, the International Transport Workers Federation, ITF, and the International Chamber of Shipping, ICS. Since the start of the crisis, this dedicated crew has been working around the clock to find answers, contacting officials from national governments, NGOs, trade unions, and other relevant groups, or directing seafarers to the appropriate organization. Seafarers and their relatives can contact the Seafarers Crisis Action Team by sending an email to info@eim.org. Thank you for your patient hearing. Please share with your friends and relatives. See you soon again.